happy Homebrew Wednesday! Greetings and salutations to everyone out there, especially all my new subscribers who have recently joined me. I'd like to say thank you very much, first of all, to Craig Farraway of CraigTube, who took up my challenge of investigating dry-hopped cider, hard apple cider. It is absolutely delicious, and I was thrilled, to see that the dry-hopped cider that he got from one of his subscribers, I forget the gent's name, my apologies, but it certainly seemed to impress Craig, and I was really, really chuffed with that, because it's the future as far as I'm concerned. Everyone needs to try it. I'm doing it. And if you've watched my videos, the chances are you're doing it as well. And if you haven't, then do it. Also, I want to say thanks very much to HarryBrew69 for his recent review of my Uber Hop IPA that I sent him. That was excellent. I'm really glad that he enjoyed it. He thoroughly enjoyed it as much as I did. And in actual fact, I think he drank the very last bottle. Because after I sent him that, I drank my bottles, the ones I had left. So, Harry, you got the very last bottle. You'll need to brew some yourself now, buddy. So, the sobriety challenge is underway. It's day three. Yes, day three. And no alcohol has passed my lips, I promise. Doing well so far. Haven't really thought about having a drink. But then, I've just been on holiday, so, you know, I'm just drinking quite a bit during my holidays. I've been thinking about what brews I can do. I have actually put a brew on to show you here. So there you are, I've put on a red wine from scratch. And that red wine consists of 8 litres of grape juice from concentrate, just red grape juice that you buy at the supermarket, a kilo of sugar, it had about a half a cup of extract, which was made by boiling down a litre of the same grape juice, and I had about half of the extract left from the last time I made red wine in the same way. I used the extract to back sweeten it. This time I had some left from that, and I just chucked it into the primary fermentation on this one, and I topped up with a couple of litres of water, put in some French oak chips, 30 gram packet for 10 litres of wine. I'm expecting to probably lose about a litre between trub, etc. And should get maybe 12, 13 bottles of wine out of that. So I'm looking forward to that. Didn't do a video, I'm afraid. But sure, you know, I'll show that on Homebrew Wednesdays, etc. Also, I want to say hello to Rago12345. I watched his video recently about rice wine. He's been doing some interesting stuff that's made me think I'd like to try that as well. He's actually done two videos, and I need to watch the first video because I didn't watch the first one, I watched the second one. The second one where he was checking on what he'd done in the first one. So I kind of did that a bit arse about tit. So I'll need to go back and check out the tit. But it looks interesting. You basically shove a load of rice, cooked rice, into a fermentation vessel and let it ferment. I had a look on YouTube, you get some videos about Korean rice wine and that kind of stuff, and they seem to have this ingredient called Noroku or something like that, Ragtapai, some kind of fermented combination of wild yeasts and barley malt extract, something along those lines. It's a bit weird. It's nothing I've ever used before. I'm not sure I'll be able to get hold of that, to be honest. But I might try my trusty Chinese market and see if they can get any for me. Also, Operation Bastard, I haven't actually managed to get that underway yet. But I'm probably going to be doing that tomorrow night. Well, it's a pretty short Homebrew Wednesday for me this week. But I've been thinking, and with subscribers in mind, new subscribers in mind, and loyal subscribers as well, I know you all are, I'm thinking about running a competition for when I hopefully and eventually reach 1,000 subscribers, if I may be so bold as to assume that I will get there in the end. So I'm going to be running a competition for my 1,000 subscribers mark, where you can win a bottle of Applejack. I'll post it worldwide. More details about that closer to when the 1,000 mark approaches. Happy Homebrew Wednesday again, guys. Cheers, 17, and thank you very much for tuning in. See ya.